Yeah. First of all, we want to understand, you know, what is meant by SAP? Yes, A-P. What is meant by SAP? Renuka, are you there?
Yes, system application, product and data processing.
Yes, very good. SAP stands for system application products for data process. My question is, you know, entire thing I explained the overview of SAP in the demo. Now my question is, how many types of projects in SAP? Like when you join as a SAP consultant, okay, which project you need to work and what is meant by that project? Okay, we have four types of projects in SAP. One is implementation project. One is implementation project, and number two is support project, and number three is rollout project, and number four is upgradation project or enhancement project. Number four is upgradation or enhancement project. So how many types of projects in SAP? Like we have four types of projects. One is implementation project and supporting project and rollout project and upgradation or enhancement project. Like what is meant by implementation project? What is meant by implementation project? This is the first question. Okay, like for example, let it be one of my client example. Let us take one of my client, like BM Steels. BM Steels Private Limited. Let's imagine one of my client, BM Steels Private Limited. Presently, they are using in Oracle Finance. Oracle Finance. You know Oracle, right? They are using Oracle ERP otherwise. Oracle ERP. Presently, they are using Oracle ERP. It means all the end users is posting accounting entries in the Oracle ERP. Okay? Means they are all the end user, means accountants, senior accountants, financial executives, all are posting accounting entries in the Oracle ERP. Then they are successfully generating the reports Oracle ERP. But this BM Steels Private Limited management take the decision, they are moving Oracle to SAP ERP. They are trying to move Oracle to SAP ERP. So what happened? As per the SAP terminology, other than SAP ERP, we are called as a legacy system. We have different ERPs. Example, Tally is one ERP. Tally is one ERP, like Tally is one ERP, and PeopleSoft is one ERP. Like in the market, different ERPs is there. So what is meant by implementation project? Implementation project means the system, entire system moved legacy system to SAP. Legacy system means other than ERP. So other than ERP to ERP. Like who will implement this SAP? Who will implement this SAP? Like consultant. consultant, who the functional consultant, technical consultant, who means different consultant will be involved to move the system non SAP to SAP. Example, Oracle ERP to SAP ERP. Presently, example, before implementing the SAP, all the end user work in the Oracle ERP, like they are trying to post accounting entries, they are trying to generate the reports. After implementation, all the end users work in the SAP ERP, like all the accounting entries and need to post in the SAP, all the reports generate in the SAP. Who will generate? End user, like accountant, financial executives, accounts managers and all. Okay, like what is meant by implementation project or non-SAP to move the system in the SAP? This is called implementation. And mostly it will take how much duration for implementation? Mostly 1 year to 2 years. If it is a large company, it will take 2 years, and it will small company, it will take minimum 1 year. So implementation project duration is minimum 1 year, maximum is 2 years. Previously, they are all the end users post in the accounting entries in the Oracle ERP. Now they are posting into the SAP ERP. Okay. Later, what is meant by supporting project? Any doubts? Any doubts here? Naveen?
No, Venkat, as of now, I don't have any doubts.
Yeah. And what is meant by supporting project? What is meant by supporting project? First implementation is completed. Later, what is meant by supporting project? Supporting project means post implemented support. John, are you there?
Yeah, I'm following.
Yeah, thank you. What is meant by supporting project? Supporting project means post implementation support. Example, let it be, this is consultant and this is the end users. What happened? For example, after completion of implementation, all the end users work in the SAP, like all the end user activities, now they are work in the SAP. Sometimes any problem occur in the SAP ERP, like end user unable to post accounting entry, end user unable to generate the reports. Any problem occur in the end user, the consultant need to support. That is called supporting project. Any problem regarding to ERP, not personal problems, regarding to SAP ERP. Okay, any problem regarding to SAP ERP of end users, like, example, I said the end user not able to post accounting entry, end user not able to generate the reports. So who will support? The consultant will support. Which consultant? Like FI consultant, CO consultant, SD consultant, different consultants is there. So that people is support. You know, like this support project duration maximum 2 years to 20 years. So like support project duration is 2 years to 20 years. Okay, like the next one, what is meant by rollout project? I will tell you one thing, the rollout project is very, very important. Concentrate here. For example, my company, my company in US. Where is my company? In US. Okay. There I am using SAP. You just catch the point. For example, I am the company owner. My company located in the US, United States of America. There I am using SAP. Okay. And due to some reason, I am expanding my company US to India. For example, I will give you one more example. You know Kia Motors. Basically, Kia Motors belongs to Korean company, South Korean company. So their business expanding Korea to India. So now what happened? Let us listen careful. For example, in the US, I am using SAP. When I expand my business US to India, what happened? SAP automatically comes US to India. Okay. So when I use the SAP in US, obviously in the India also I can use SAP only. Okay. But there is some problem. What is that problem? Like US currency is different, Indian currency is different. US legal rules and regulations is different, Indian legal rules and regulation is different. And US taxation is different, Indian taxation is different. So when you want to move SAP US to India, you need to implement taxation, like tax, like currency, like, you know, legal rules like ETC, etc. So you need to implement this type of specific topics, that is called rollout project. What is meant by rollout project? Already company have using in the SAP, due to some reason like expanding one country to another country, when you want to move the SAP one country to another country, that is called rollout project. Okay. And later, what is meant by upgradation or enhancement project? Upgradation and enhancement project. Upgradation and enhancement project means lower version to higher version. So before going to that, what is the duration of rollout project? And mostly 6 months to 8 months only. Okay. And what is meant by upgradation or enhancement project? Upgradation and enhancement project means lower version to higher version. For example, now our people is using ERP, ERP 6.0, EHP 7. This is one version. Okay, ERP means Enterprise Resource Planning, and 6.0 EHP means Enhancement Package. Enhancement EHP. EHP. EHP means Enhancement Package 7th version. Enhancement Package 7th version. Okay. So now the people is using in this version. Like this version too, we are moving S4HANA. we are moving. S for Hana. What happened? SAP S4 HANA. Like this is the one version, this is another version. Okay, we are upgrading or we are enhancement of one version to another version. We are called enhancement project or upgradation project. So this will also minimum like 1 year, like 1 year to 2 years duration. 2 years. So any doubt, anyone, any doubt here? Implementation project, non-SAP to SAP. Supporting project, after implementing the SAP, all the end users work in the SAP. Any problem occurred in the recording to SAP, the consultant need to support. Okay, then what is meant by rollout project? Rollout project means currently my company in US, due to some reach I am using an SAP. Due to some reason, I am expanding my business US to India. Not only India, one country to another country. My answer is one country to another country. Okay, like so SAP need to move like US to India, but there is some problem like taxation problem, currency problem and legal rules and etc. Okay, and yeah. And what is mean by enhancement project? Lower version to higher version. So anyone, any doubt? Renuka, Mr. John, and Raju, anyone?
No, sir, clear.
I have just a question.
Yes, please.
Yeah. For example, a company was using, for example, Oracle.
Okay.
And the management decided to move from Oracle, for example, for the moment, most of the company are using S/4HANA.
Yeah.
And the management decide that due to the business, they want to move from Oracle to S/4HANA. Is it possible or not?
Yeah, it's possible. Yes, it is possible. That is called implementation project. S/4HANA is one version. See. S/4HANA is one version. This is also SAP only. S/4HANA means SAP only. S/4HANA is a one version. It is possible. This is called implementation project.
Fine.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yes, everyone. Do one thing. My first question is how to open the SAP. So this is first you can activate your server. I mean when you take the online access, obviously they can activate. And this is SAP logon pad. You just double click on SAP logon pad. And see this one, EHP 7. Which version we are learning? EHP enhancement package 7 SR2G including GST. The latest version we are learning, EHP 7 version. Okay, this is the version. You just double click on here.
Venkat,
Navin. Yes, please. Can you speak louder?
Venkat. So this is our new version, right?
Yeah, this is the new version in the ERP.
Okay, then what? Okay, and S/4HANA also we are using, right?
S/4HANA is coming. S/4HANA is coming. Yeah. Some people upgrade the system ERP to S/4HANA.
Okay.
Now we are discussing ECC. Okay, not S/4HANA.
Okay,
we are discussing ECC.
Okay.
For example,
okay.
And mostly 2025, all see this one. This is ERP, EHP, that's like this is the ERP package, like ECC, okay? And the move S/4HANA, this is the, coming. All the systems, all the companies moved, they are targeting 1 year, 2025. Like all the systems moved, ERP to S/4HANA, like ECC to S/4HANA. Now we are discussing ECC.
So that means still S/4HANA or still S/4HANA not implemented. Most of the companies.
Some companies they are implemented. Okay. But most of companies still they are using in ECC only, ERP ECC only. But SAP has given one target, 2025. All the companies like enhancement of ECC to S/4HANA. Okay, still there are some companies they are trying to move ECC to S/4HANA, okay, and a lot of companies using ECC only. For example, when you want to learn S/4HANA, first you want to learn ERP ECC, then only you are able to understand S/4HANA. This is upgradation version. Without ECC, you are unable to understand S/4HANA. This is also a major aspect.
Okay, so okay. There is a connection between both S/4HANA and as well as the old version, the ERP.
Can you speak louder?
No. So that means once we learn in the ERP, EHP version, and there are small changes will be there in S/4HANA.
Yes, you catch the point. Yeah, very good. There is a, for example, one second. My yen ma sound?
What?
Yen a sound?
What?
A door eman japo, nak disturbance gundi.
Yes.
Ma, door is koma.
Yes, sir.
Silent. Yeah, yes. Yes. For example, how to open SAP? You just double click on, already I double clicked. And here, what is meant by client? I will explain you later what is meant by client, why you are using client and all. Basically, this client roles and responsibilities take care by SAP basis people, but obviously we require some knowledge of this client. I will explain you later. Then you can enter username and password. You can ask from who give online access. You can ask that person to what is username and password. Okay, even that person will explain how to open the SAP. Yeah, and example, SAP user password Poonam at 123, press enter. See this one. Concentrate here. When I enter username and password, open with SAP Easy Access. SAP Easy Access. Now concentrate here. You just understand. We have two types of roles, right? One is end user role and one is consultant role. Now my question is, where the end user is work and where the consultant is work, and which screen, okay, which screen work in the end user and which screen work in the consultant? Everyone, this meeting will be disconnected within 1 minute. Okay, you please rejoin again. Okay. Yes, please wait for some more people is joining. Give me 2 minutes, huh?
Okay, sir.
Sunil, Sunil, are you there? Hi, Sunil.
Hi, sir.
Hi. Sunil, Rajkumar is joined different link, so please intimate to join this link. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Give me 1 minute, 1 minute, please.
Okay, no problem.
Yeah. Navin, you are the end user of SAP, right? Navin, are you there?
Yes, Venkat.
You are the end user, yeah. You know.
Yes, end user.
And everyone, I will intimate you one thing. We can create one WhatsApp group for all people. At the time of practice, any doubts, you just post in that group. Any group, our internally, we will discuss and resolve any problem at the time of practice. Okay?
Okay, Venkat, sure.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. And so, where we are? And we are, see this one? And where the end user is work and where the consultant is work. Where the end user is work and where the consultant is work. So when I enter username and password, SAP Easy Access will be open. In this SAP Easy Access screen, this is the SAP Easy Access screen, work in the end user. Who will work in the SAP Easy Access screen? SAP Easy Access screen work in the end user. Like he is able to post accounting entries, he is able to generate the reports. Entire thing I will explain you later. How to post accounting entries, how to post generate the reports, entire thing I can explain you later. First, you need to understand where the end user is work. Where the consultant is work. Okay, the end user is work in the SAP Easy Access screen. Example, how to post accounting entries. Example, I'm saying SAP menu and accounting and financial accounting, like a general ledger, accounts receivable, accounts payable, banking, fixed asset, lot of subtopics is there. Like example, general ledger and document posting. Like this is the accounting entry posting. See this one, incoming payment, outgoing payment, and general ledger posting. Here the different accounting entries posting in the end user. Even here, like here reporting. See this one, reporting, different reports generating the end user. Okay, let's example, this is one end user posting, this is the T codes and this is the path. Okay, so where the end user is work in the SAP easy access screen, in the SAP easy access screen, end user is work or end user on work in the SAP easy access screen. So everyone, you just take care, listen, concentrate here, how to work. This is called menu bar. What is this? This is called menu bar. And this is called toolbar. This is called toolbar. And this is command box. This is command box. Go on mute, please. I think. Anyone? Go on mute, please. Any doubts, you just unmute and ask me. Okay? And this is called ribbon bar. This is called ribbon bar. And this is SAP menu. This is SAP menu. And this is SAP status bar. This is SAP status bar. And this is the standard bar. You just understand what is meant by SAP easy access screen. Once again, I'm explaining. This is called menu bar. And this is called toolbar. All the tools. I will explain you one by one how to use the toolbar, how to use the SAP menu bar, every option you need to learn. Okay, and later, first you understand what is the names and that, and menu bar and toolbar and command field or command box and ribbon bar. This is the ribbon bar and this is the SAP menu and this is the status bar and this is standard bar. You know, every system have one standard bar. Okay, and the SAP easy access screen, the end user work on SAP easy access screen, like they are able to post accounting entries and they are able to generate the reports. Okay, accounts receivable, accounting entry, invoice posting, invoice posting, like incoming payment posting, credit memo posting, like debit memo posting, like all the accounting entries is able to post in the easy access screen. And later we will explain. Okay, and where the consultant will work, in the which screen working in the consultant, you just catch the point here. And this is the command box. This is the command box, like enter here SPRO. This is the command box, enter here SPRO. SPRO is the one T code. What is meant by T code? I will explain you later. Enter here SPRO, press enter, click on here SAP reference IMG. Click on here SAP reference IMG. In this screen, this is implementation guide. This is implementation guide. In this screen, consultant will be work here. All the consultants, FI consultant, CO consultant, technical consultant, all the SDMM, all the consultants work in the IMG screen or SPRO screen. This is called IMG screen, implementation guide. This is the implementation guide screen. Example, let's go to when you want to create the enterprise structure. Sorry, go on mute, please. Enterprise structure and definition, financial accounting. Create the company, create controlling area, create business area, create the functional area, and different things will be work on here. Okay, so where the consultant will work, consultant work in the SPRO screen. Type here SPRO and click on here SAP reference IMG. In this screen, consultant will be work. Okay, and now my question is, what is meant by T code? T-code means transactional code. T-code means transactional code. Renuka, are you there?
Yes, sir.
In the MS Office, we have shortcut keys, right? Like in the MS Office, we have shortcut keys.
Yes.
MS Word, MS Excel, we have some shortcut keys. Like in the SAP, we have the T codes. In the MS Office, we treat it as a shortcut keys. In the SAP, we are called as a T codes, transactional code. Okay, John, are you able to understand what is meant by T code? Every transaction
yes.
have one shortcut key. As per
yes.
the SAP terminology, don't called as a shortcut key. We are called as a transactional code in the short form T codes. Okay, example, let it be. Example, end user want to post one general ledger accounting posting. GL accounting posting. End user need to post one accounting entry posting. Okay, need to post one accounting entry posting. Example, I'm going one path. Example, SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting. This is the example. I will tell you later very clearly how to post and all everything. Okay, first you need to understand means T code. First you just focus on T code. What is meant by T code? Transactional code. This is the shortcut key, like MS Office shortcut key. Okay, T code means transactional code. Example, end user need to post GL accounting entry posting. So when the end user want to post GL accounting entry posting, either he is able to go through path or either he can enter T code. Example, let it be SAP menu, how to post GL accounting entry posting. SAP menu, accounting entry posting, accounting like financial accounting and general ledger. This is the path and document entry posting. Here what is the T code? FB50. Here you need to post accounting entry posting. You just double click on here. So here the end user need to post accounting entry posting and go back. Here need to post accounting entry posting. Example, I don't know path. Accounting entries, financial accounting entry posting, I don't know path. I want to use T code. What is the T code? Instead of coming this path, you can use this T code FB50. Okay, do one thing, go back. Here in the command box, enter here FB50. Press enter. See this one, directly come here. Either you can go through path, SAP menu, accounting, financial accounting, general ledger, and document entry and posting. Every transaction, example, you need to post incoming payment, F-06. Either you just come through path and double click on this. This here you need to post incoming payment. How to post? What is meant by fields? I will explain you later. First you can understand T code. Either you can come through T code or otherwise go back. Otherwise you can enter T code F-06. Press enter. See this one, this is the screen comes like this. And every transaction, it may be consultant transaction, it may be functional transactions, every transaction have one T code. Okay, in this mostly we have more than 2 lakhs T codes is there. So you need to remind mostly every day you can use mostly 50 to 60 T codes, that's it. Okay, even I will tell you one example. in the English language, in the English language, we have more than 10 lakhs words, but every day we can use mostly 150 words. Listen to it. So same way in the SAP, we have more than 2 lakhs T codes, but we are not use all the T codes. Okay, then yes, I will give you important T codes for the to crack the interview. Okay, then see this one. For example, go to SPRO screen and SAP reference IMG and enterprise structure, definition, financial accounting. See this one, even every transaction have one T code. So how to find the T code? To find the T codes for consultant, what can I do? Go to additional information, display keys, IMG activities. See this one. Otherwise, you just note it down this path. Okay. How to find like this T code? Additional information, display keys, IMG activities. Okay. And you just click on your IMG activities. The last 4 digit is the T code. When you want to create the company, what is the T code? OX15. When you want to create the functional area, example business area, what is the T code? OX03. Example, when you want to create the company, either you just, what is the T code? You just keep it on OX15. When you want to create the company, either you can come the path. What is the path? SPRO, enter, SAP reference IMG, and enterprise structure, definition, financial accounting. When you want to create the company, you just double click on this. And here, click on your new entry. Here you want to create the company. How to create the company, I will tell you later. And instead of coming this path, and you can use T code. I don't know this path. So what can I do? Here I can enter T code. Here in the SAP Easy Access screen, here I can enter T code. What is the T code? Rajkumar, what is the T code? Everyone, what is the T code?
OX15.
Very good. OX15. Press enter. Yeah, very good. OX15. Press enter. See this one? This screen will come. Click on your new entry, then create the company. Like T code, like a shortcut key. T code full form is transactional code. Every transactional have one T code. Okay. And remaining I will tell you later. I will tell you one thing. And our class Monday to Friday, like every day 7 a.m. IST to like 8:30 AM IST. So every day, this is the first class, that is the reason I taken 7:30. But next class onwards, we have Monday to Friday, we have the classes every day morning 7 AM IST Indian time to 8:30 AM IST. Okay, and today is the first class, tomorrow is Saturday. So that is our first Saturday. That is the reason tomorrow also I can take the class. The next Monday onwards, we have the classes Monday to Friday, like 7 a.m. IST to 8:30 a.m. IST Indian time. Okay. Tomorrow we have the class. Why? Because tomorrow is the first Saturday. That is the reason I can take the class. Next Monday onwards, this is the rules. Okay, every day we have 1.5 hour class. Okay, everyone, are you following?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So any doubts regarding these T codes and all? Remaining basics we will understand tomorrow. Okay. We have lot of basics. First, you need to learn the basics. Later, you need to go to configuration. Later, you need to create the master data. Later, you can post accounting entries. Later, you need to generate the reports. We have lot of. You need to learn lot of subject. So we will try to. Finally, our target is to get the job for very good package. Okay, we need to work as a. I mean, we need to work as a team. Okay, I can create one WhatsApp group. At the time of practice, you just post any error. Post in that group, post only regarding subject, SAP subject. Don't post good morning, hi, hello, how are you, festival wishes. Don't post irrelevant things. Please post only SAP subject there. Okay. Okay, everyone. Chalo, sign out the class.
Okay.
Okay,
sir.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, tomorrow we have the class. Please join at 7:30 only. 7:30 a.m. Okay. Same timing.
Venkat Navin here.
Yes, Navin. Please tell me.
Zoom meeting ID will be changed on every day.
No. Zoom meeting ID. No, Zoom meeting ID not okay. Change every day. Same whatever okay. Zoom joined today, you just please join tomorrow. Same Zoom meeting ID.
Okay, Venkat, sure.
Okay. In okay, case of any sure. Changes, I will update. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes, thanks everyone. Yes, John. Thank you. Thanks for joining.
Okay. Thanks a lot for your
thank
teaching.
You, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you, Venkat.
Okay.